Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about Power BI release February 2023. What are the different features that Power BI has released as part of this catch up with Nags series? Let's try to jump into today's topic. Before moving to our today's content, this channel contains a free content worth $1,250 and 100,000 INR. That covers Power BI, SQL, MSBI, and basics of Azure. Please utilize this free content, share this content with your friends and colleagues. So, Power BI release 2023 February. There are a lot of updates from Power BI team, especially in the reporting side. Most of the features I like it. Like one of the beautiful thing is like till now when you want to configure or do some kind of formatting based on the text, it is not possible. Right now, conditional formatting based on string fields. So those who are familiar, you can understand this. You can choose the text field first category and first, then you can choose the value. For audio, it should be red. So you can see here, the for audio category, everything becomes red here. So this is how you can format it. There are a lot of other things you can think of, how you can format your reports, right? So this is a wonderful feature. And smart narrative visual summary icon, I'm not sure how good it is. And that is the formatting image within a table matrix. So this is another drawback earlier because Power BI releases on ad hoc basis, but now you see you cannot format it properly. Now there is option to format your images that fit into particular size. And you can update the base theme in Power BI. So you can see these features here. An easy way you can update your current theme in Power BI desktop. So you can follow through the steps, like go to that theme and you can choose the customized current theme. Then you can update your theme, right? So these are the different colors you can choose. And moving on to other things, these are not so interesting. Text box visual indentation. Yes, so basically like you can align or you can do some kind of indentation in the text box. Now this is a really good feature. And now accessible report themes, again I think it's related to themes only. This is again an interesting thing. Now recently they have released like page navigator visual, where customized visual pages in the page navigator visual, you can customize the sizes so that you can have a landing page that will help you to navigate to the other pages. But earlier you cannot customize much. Now you have a lot of options to customize. That is what this page navigation customization. Then I like this feature. As I said, there are a lot of features I like in this release. Enhanced row level security editor. This is a nightmare for someone who is new to Power BI. Apply how I can apply the logics, whether it is and or condition, to understand it, right? So here they have some kind of GUI right now, so you can add it. And obviously you have option to switch back to DAX editor. Those who are already familiar with applying the same condition in DAX, you can still write in DAX. So here you have option two, you have GUI kind of thing, right? So this is one good feature in RLS part. Then coming to here, there is new DAX function linest and line stx. I'm not sure what are those. I mean, let's read through it. Two functions perform linear regression leveraging the least square methods to calculate straight line that best fits the given data and return a table describing that line. I'm really not sure about where we can apply these functions, because typical data analysis world, we will not go deep into linear regressions, all of the steps. Definitely I will make some video on this, where this DAX functions can be used. I will find a use case and then I will demonstrate in a new video. Let's skip this for now. Then again, there are a lot of connector updates. Then one last thing I like here is I hope we already seen this new get data experience in the Power BI services. In the services, you can see different way you can create a new content from files and database and discover content. So there is a new GUI available, and also there is a upload button option. I'm currently using this option. This is really good. You can upload from your desktop, or if you sync it from the SharePoint, it will automatically sync. So this is really good one. And there is a compact view right now in the goals and the metrics. So here you can switch between the compact view and the list view. Then you have something major updates in the paginated reports. So parameter pane for paginated reports has enhanced, because once you have a paginated reports, obviously you need to have parameters. I mean, most of the reports will have a parameter, as you can see Power BI as a statistics, like out of 70% of all user base uses the parameters for the paginated reports. So they have enhanced some parameters pane here. And also you can able to create paginated report from a data mart. So the data marts, I hope I didn't make any video on this, but definitely I will surely make video soon. So you can create paginated reports from the data mart. Then you can have a capacity planning for paginated reports. Then there are a lot of third party visuals, and this one I like much, that is milestone trend analysis chart, identify milestone trends. That basically it was existing visual. Now there is a theme available. You can have a dark mode theme, so you can see here how project has evolved. Now currently in what state, whether it's in development, testing, and UAT completed, and across the timeline you see here. So this is what this report is all about. And apart from that, you have this visual, as usual, from the Zoom Start Drill Down Donut Pro. Let's use it to create visual appealing donut charts by easy data exploration. I think this is already available. Right now they have some advanced or amended some more features in this pro version of it. Basically you can see multi-level drill down up to 9 levels. Earlier when you can also use this free chart, like it will be visually appealing. Like when you click on it, it will move to a next level by doing some graphics. But when you have a free version, it will make you to drill down only 2 levels or some. There is some restriction. Right now when you have a pro version, you can drill down up to 9 levels. So this is another good feature, like it. So that's it about this month release. I hope you enjoyed this video. You understand I have summarized some of the highlights and the features that I like the much. And if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.